Hello, I'm Congressman James Lankford from the great state of Oklahoma. Tomorrow, President Obama will be sworn in for a second term. Though we disagree on many areas of policy, I join my fellow Americans in pledging to pray for the president, his family, and our nation in the days ahead. During the last 4 years, our nation has faced difficult economic times. Millions of Americans are still out of work, and the cost of groceries, gas, and health care continues to rise. In the long history of our nation, we have never increased spending and federal debt faster than we have in this period. In the book of Proverbs, it says a wise man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. Unfortunately, Washington is consuming our children's inheritance. Americans get it. Federal overspending is now actually dragging our economy down rather than lifting our families up. It's time for Democrats and Republicans to work together to create a plan to get our nation and our families back on track. Every family and every business has a budget. Our nation should have a budget as well. In fact, every year the president is required by law to submit a budget proposal to Congress by February the 4th. But the Obama administration has already informed Congress that for the fourth time in 5 years, it will be late submitting a budget to your representatives. Unfortunately, the president has already missed more budget deadlines than any of his predecessors. The House and Senate are also required by law to submit a budget each year, not surprisingly, by April 15th, tax day. But the Democratic-run Senate hasn't approved such a resolution in almost 4 years, 1,361 days to be exact. This is not the result of Washington gridlock. Majority Leader Harry Reid said it would be foolish for his party in the Senate to produce a budget. We disagree. With more than $16 trillion in debt, we believe it's foolish not to have a budget. In the House, led by Budget Committee Chairman Paul Ryan, we will again meet our legal obligation to pass a budget on time. Our budget will moderate spending, pay our bills, and keep the government running. Most importantly, it will be a plan to slowly but surely walk our nation out of debt, deficit, and decline. On your behalf, we will insist that the Democrats who run the rest of Washington do the same. This debate is often argued in numbers and figures, but it's really about families like yours that bear the burden of a slow economy. Constant uncertainty, ever-changing government rules chase our jobs and opportunities overseas. When day-to-day life costs more and jobs pay less, we don't solve the problem by delaying our federal spending decisions, raising taxes, or refusing to tackle our nation's most pressing economic challenges. You deserve better. With the swearing-in of a new Congress, in the inauguration of President Obama, this is an opportunity for a fresh start. But because government debt really does affect all of us, Republicans will not simply provide a blank check for uncontrolled spending, irrational borrowing, and constant nickel and dime tax increases. We should cut Washington's budget, not your family's budget. The issues we face today are not impossible obstacles. They're merely the challenges of our time. We have the guidance of great leaders of the past who have faced tougher challenges than this with grace and dignity, like Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. Dr. King once said, "Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others?" It's a good word for all of us, and a clarion call that should ring in our ears on his birthday weekend. Regardless of our differences, we all have the same dreams for a better future for our kids and grandkids. I pray my children will grow up with your children in a nation where they can enjoy the shade of God's blessings and the freedom that has uniquely been the United States of America.